Okay, so let us go ahead. I said that another kind of situation we encounter where, let me delete this, we encounter another kind of situation where what we are trying to measure is actually a function of x. Z is a function of x. We have measured x and we are trying to find z, some function, whatever that function can be. Now, in such situations where we are talking about a function of z, the functional form has to be given, and let us assume the functional form to be something like this. Something like that, whatever it is. So, here I have x and here I have z, right, and this is my function of x. In that case, I have made a measurement of x and we are trying to find out what will be the mean value of z. What will be the mean value of z and what will be the error in z? Let us try to work that out. So, here suppose I have measured the x bar value here. So, x bar, the mean value measured is here. In that case, we can draw a line going up, and then I will just delete this so that we can go to the left. Sorry. So, if x is this and z is a function, then following that function, this will be the measured value of z, sorry. This will be the measured value of z. What about the error? The error will be a range something like this. So, if we have that range, then we can go up. We can go up like this and come to the left like that. So, this much, so this will be the error, this is the this is x bar, this is x bar minus delta x and this is the x bar plus delta x. So, this point is x bar plus delta x and this point is x bar minus delta x and these then propagate like this. As a result, this becomes z bar plus delta z, this becomes z bar minus delta z. So, we have this error propagating to this error propagating to this error. It is easy to then infer that the z bar will be the same function. I would say that functional form has to be known, x bar. If the functional form of known is known and x bar is known, we can know z bar, but your the delta z will propagate depending on the slope here. If the slope is smaller than 1, then actually the error will reduce while if it is bigger than 1, the error will increase. So it depends on the derivative of the function at that point. So this is actually the derivative of the function, and derivative of the function is the dz dx. When the dz dx is different at different parts, it has to be calculated at x bar. So it has to be calculated at x bar, and not only that, depending on whether it is a positive slope or negative slope, there will be no difference. So it is actually the mod of that times your delta x. That will be the value of the delta z. Is that clear from the construction that I have shown in the graph? Good. So your delta z is actually given as a the error in z, error in x times the slope of the function calculated at the mean value of x. So this is how we calculate the value of the z. So we can again express z as z bar plus minus delta z, the error bar. What if z is a function of two variables x and y? What then? Well, it is not difficult to see that then we will have to depict the situation as so then this is my x, this is my y, and then this is my z, and the function will then take the form of some kind of a surface. So it will be something like this. Something like this. So if you have a surface, that means z is a function of x and y, will be some kind of a surface, and then I have a measured value of x and y which can be somewhere here. So if I have a measured value of x and y somewhere here, so it is this is my measured value of x, this is my measured value of y, and we are trying to find out this. So obviously we can find out the measured value of z as the function which is known of x bar and y bar. That is not a problem. Now let us consider, I have got a x bar, and let us consider a perturbation, some error in x, and let us call it say delta x. It is not the standard error I am talking about, I am just talking about a perturbation, a change from the value of x bar. Also take it this way, that if I had measured the x bar again, I would have got a different result. A third time it would got a different result. So there could be different results. This is another result. The another result is x bar plus delta x. Okay. And similarly, there can be another result. You measured it again. That means whenever you measure it, you are measuring with a number of readings, and you have measured again with 25 readings, and you got another value of the x bar, which is the earlier x bar plus delta x and earlier x bar plus delta y or minus delta y, whatever it is. In that case, the delta z, the way in this case we had obtained it in terms of the slope, in this case we have to obtain it in terms of the slope in the x direction and the slope in the y direction, which means in terms of the partial derivatives. So this will be equal to the delta z, del x times this perturbation in x plus del z del y times this perturbation in y. Now, so these are the deviations of the data points, this delta x, this delta capital delta x is the deviation from the value of x bar that you have obtained, and we are trying to find out due to these deviations in x and y what would be the deviation in z, and that can be found from this formula. But now we are trying to find out what will be the standard error, standard deviation in z. So, we proceed by stating that standard deviation, and let me work it here. Let me try to work it out here. So, you have this standard. Let us work it out in terms of the variance. Okay, standard error, the variance would be S z square. Okay, how do you define the variance? Variance is the difference of a data point from the mean value that you have obtained, which in this case is delta z. So its summation, it is delta z, this is the difference between the value obtained minus the mean value, its square summed over all data minus n minus 1, that is the definition of the variance. Now, this is something that we know. So, we can substitute it here. So, this will become 1 by n minus 1 summation of its square del z del x del delta x plus del z del y delta y square. Okay, then we can expand that as 1 by n minus 1. This will be, let me put the whole thing in a bracket, del z del x square delta x square plus del z del y square delta y square plus 2 del z del x del z del y delta x delta y, this whole thing, right. Now, this is 1 by n minus 1, we keep it, but now we would like to put the summation inside, so that it becomes del z del x square, the summation over delta x square plus del z del y square summation over delta y square plus twice del z del x del z del y summation over delta x delta y. Well, we can also put the 1 by n minus 1 in all these quantities, but we'll do that slowly. Now, let us see what this is, this. So, let me write it separately. This was 1 by n minus 1 delta x square. So sigma delta x square. What is that? So 1 by n minus 1 and this. This is we are keeping separate. So what is this? This is actually the standard, this is the variance of x. 1 by n minus 1 and the summation over delta y square is nothing but this the variance of y. Okay. So, the variance of x will be multiplied by this, variance of y will be multiplied by that, but what is this? Notice that it is a summation over delta x delta y. Delta x and delta y are the errors, the perturbations. So, these could be positive or negative, and as a result of which this product could also be positive or negative, and if you take a large number of such data points, then positives and negatives will cancel off, and as a result of this, this part will equal 0 for a large number of readings and therefore, the whole thing will be 0, which means we started from delta z square. So, let us write the result. So, S z square then becomes this term del z del x square S x square plus del z del y square S y square. So, it is clear then that the variances in this case are related in this way, and therefore, the standard deviation as square root of this whole thing. This is how the error would propagate from the error in x and the error in y to the error in z, and the measured value of z will be stated like this, and the standard error in z will be stated like this. Square root of del z del x square standard error of x square plus del z del y I should not write here, I should write down there, let me write it separately. S I should write the delta z will be square root of del z del x square delta x square plus del z del y square delta y square. This is how the error in x and y would propagate into the error in z. So, having the value measured of x and the value of y, which means the mean value of x and mean value of y measured, standard errors in x, standard error in y measured, this is how it will propagate into the standard error in z. And this way the errors propagate. Often we do make measurements about things which are different from things that we need, and they are somehow related, and depending on that relationship we can find out ways of stating the result of measurement of the thing that we ultimately want to measure or state. So, this is how we ultimately make the measurements and state the results in a paper. Thank you.